In this video, we'll be discussing about the constraint satisfaction problem in artificial intelligence. So, constraint satisfaction problem is basically a problem in which we will be solving a constraint in order to satisfy the required problem domain. So, constraint satisfaction problem basically says that it is defined by a set of variables, that is x1, x2 up till xn, and set of conditions, that is c1, c2, cn, satisfying these variables such that each of the variable xi has a non-empty domain di of possible values. It means that for each of the variable there will be a domain di, and for each variable there will be at least one value present in that, and minimum value is 1. Next is, we'll define the problem formulation. Now, this is the way or the manner in which the CSP problem is being solved. So, in this, we have 4 points. First, we'll define the initial state. Initial state is from where we will be start solving the problem. Next is the successor function. Successor function is chosen in such a way that it should not affect the next value that we are going to provide in order to solve the problem. Next is the goal test. Goal test is to check whether the following satisfaction constraint we have put forth is being completed or not, such that we have reached the goal state or not. Next is the path cost. Path cost is the value which we are assigning in order to solve the problem, and the minimum value for path cost is 1. Means at least a path cost of 1 is used to solve the problem so that we can go further in completing the CSP problem. Next, we will define the CSP problem. Now, in this, we have been given a problem definition, that is, we need to color each region as RGB. RGB stands for red, green, and blue, in such a way that no neighboring region has the same color. Means it's like a big territory is there, or a continent is there. In that continent, we have many of the states or regions, such that each of the region should be given different color than its neighboring one. Now, this is the problem basically. Now we will be defining the variables. So, in this, the variables will be, now we will be having a few of the states. So, for that, we will be writing Western Australia as WA, then Northern Territory, then Tasmania, next Queensland, next New South Wales, and South Australia. So, we have in total of 6 variables, and one more is there, that is Victoria. So, 7 variables are there. So, with these 7 variables, we will be solving the constraint satisfaction problem. And the domain is that we will be defining, or we will be solving this problem along with these variables by considering these RGB values. Means we have to color these regions according to this problem definition. And our constraint is that no variable should conflict with each other. Such that if Western Australia is given some color, for example, if Western Australia is red, then it should not conflict with Northern Territory, for example. Means if Western Australia is given as R, Northern Territory can take G or B values from this set. So this is the problem definition. Now we will move on to the formulation of how to solve this problem. So for this, we have a continent. This is our continent. This is one part of the territory. This is our Western Australia. this is our Northern Territory, this is Southern Australia, this is Queensland, this is New South Wales, and this is Victoria, and one here is Tasmania. Now we have to color each of these regions according to the constraint satisfaction problem. So for that we will first prepare a table. So in this table we have our initial domain. Our variables, that is WA, WT, SA, Q, NSW, V and T. So first we'll arrange the domains. First we'll assign one variable or one domain for each of this, and then we'll solve the problem. So initial domain for all this is like default value WA can take is RGB. Out of this WA can take any of this value. Similarly for WT, SA, similarly for all these variables. Means these are the default values that all these can take. Next we'll assign, continue to assign each of this to one of these territories. Now first, after when we assign WA as R, now we are assigning WA, that is Western Australia, as red. Now so in this we'll assign R to this, so accordingly we will color this. Western Australia we have assigned as red. Now Northern Territory, I'm sorry, this is Northern Territory, this is NT. Now Northern Territory can take either G or B values, but not R, because it will violate the constraint. So we'll write here as G or B, G or B, and this can take green or blue, and all these can take any of this, like RGB, RGB or RGB, any of this. Next, once we have assigned WASR, we'll assign NT as some value, green or blue. So after we assign NT as green, now when NT is green, just put a G here and R here. So obviously SA can take B, and accordingly we'll fill this. So SA is green here. NT is green here, I'm sorry, NT is green, and so I don't have a green color here, so I will keep it as empty. And so SA is blue by default, so this cannot be, this Q cannot be simply white or simply green, or it has to be given some other values. So I'm filling this RGB, and this can take R, G and R. And this isolated continent can take any of the values that are GB. Next we have to assign one more, that after we assign Tasmania to red, if we assign red to this, then what all values can these take? So our South Australia is blue, so South Australia I am marking as blue. So accordingly you have to color this. And R, after T is equal to R, now T is equal to R, and these can take RGB and RGR. So unique values have been taken by these variables satisfying the domains, and this is how we solve the constraint satisfaction problem. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.